In fluid dynamics, the conservation of momentum is expressed via the Navier-Stokes equations. Difficult nonlinear partial differential equation, which yield, in principle, a velocity field for a given pressure distribution. Solving these PDEs is very difficult, though. In fluid flow through porous media, we can make some simplifying assumptions and average the equations. This yields the so-called Darcy's law, which is much easier than the full Navier-Stokes equation. Originally, Darcy's law was determined experimentally in the 19th century by Darcy. Later on, it was derived from Navier-Stokes. In this video, you will learn about Darcy's law along the same lines. So, what was the experiment of Darcy about? He put a column of sand. He put them straight, by the way. In later experiments, they also put tilted columns. So, column with sand, pour in water, and measure the volumetric outflow. That's all. But what he observed was just this volumetric outflow Q was proportional to the height difference, delta H, inversely proportional to length L, inversely proportional to the viscosity of the fluid, and proportional to the area A, area over here, outflow area. So this was determined experimentally. So it's, you could call this a phenomenological law. So what happens then if you convert this to velocities? Well, first you want to give this proportionality constant here a name. In order to do so, first you convert delta H in terms of pressures. Well, delta H is of course related to pressure difference. And then this proportionality constant over here, K, is called the permeability. So this is actually the defining equation of what the permeability is. Then you have a volumetric outflow Q. You can divide that, of course, by the area through which the outflow goes. It gives you meters per second, so that gives you a dimension of velocity. And this velocity is called the Darcy velocity, U. And you see if you divide Q by A, and you have your delta P over L, and it becomes a gradient of P. So what you get is Darcy velocity, which is kind of a volumetric velocity, equals gradient of P times our new permeability divided by mu with the minus sign because you're flowing from high to low pressure. So at this point, this is a phenomenological law. You measure something, you measure that your volumetric outflow is proportional to your pressure gradient. But it's very similar, for example, to Ohm's law, where your U, your flow velocity, is replaced by I, the velocity of the current flow, the flow of the electrons. The gradients of P is replaced by the gradients of the electric potential, and your K over mu, which is kind of transmissibility, is replaced by 1 over R, where R is the resistance. So actually, Darcy's law closely resembles Ohm's law. It's very similar to that. Well, and later on, this Darcy's law was also derived. So first part is experimentally. Second part is deriving it from first principles. It was derived from Stokes' equation, from the conservation of momentum. So what you need to do? You need to average over some representative elementary volume, and you have to neglect some small terms. And then starting out with Stokes' equation, you get indeed also to Darcy's law. So what Darcy's law in fact expresses is conservation of momentum. Now let's turn to this new constant K, to this permeability. So what are its dimensions? What is its size approximately? What's called a total permeability, K. What about the dimension? Well, let's look at this equation. Let's compare dimensions. Then we see meter per second on the left-hand side. Dimension of K, which we want to find. Dimension of the gradient of pressure equals Pascal over meter. And the viscosity has dimension Pascal sec. So what you see, Pascals cancel out, seconds cancel out. And you see that the dimension of your permeability is meter squared. Now, if you compute those permeabilities for rock, sand or clay, you see that permeabilities are really, really small if you express them in meters. They're like in a range of 10 minus 19 meters squared to 10 minus 7 meters squared. Typical permeability is 10 minus 13 meters squared. So in SI units, those become very small. So that's why often in porous media, another unit is used, the darcy. So the engineer is also named after a unit. So a unit of one darcy is about 10 minus 12 meters squared. So that means that with this unit, permeabilities become more order unity in terms of darcys. Well, I like to keep the units at the number of different units minimal. So I prefer to express permeabilities in meters squared. And the price you have to pay is that those permeabilities become really, really small in this unit.